Hello friends, my name is Dr. Mova Srinivas. I am a cardiologist. I am working at MaxCure Hospitals, Madhapur. Today, I have come before you to discuss about high BP, which with medical terms, which is called hypertension. You know, there are multiple videos to treat hypertension, what are the causes of hypertension, it's called high BP and all that. But is high BP reversible? So that's what I want to discuss with you today. Is it permanent that if a person has high BP branded, like you have high BP, it's like typical comes we call BP. So is it for life that you are with BP, with high BP? Should you take tablets for life or can we reverse this? It is quite reversible. I'll tell you how. See, commonly most patients who come to me with a diagnosis of high BP suffer from a condition called as anxiety. Mostly the anxiety is the primary condition which causes high BP and high heart rates also. So if the high BP is associated with high heart rate, probably the patient has anxiety neurosis, preparation anxiety. 70% of people who have hypertension, at least my OPD, are having anxiety neurosis. There is one more condition called as white coat hypertension. So whenever a patient sees white coat, his BP goes up. This is quite common. This is also a variant of anxiety. It is seen in 50 to 60% of people who come to cardiology OPDs. So it's not a really serious problem as anxiety and neurosis. So in these patients, the first reading could be high. So typically what we do is we ask the patient to just wait in the OPD for 15 minutes and ask the nurse or any other attendant who is present in the OPD to take the BP once again. Typically, after 15 to 20 minutes, the BP starts falling at least by 10 to 15 millimeters of mercury. The more the patient relaxes, the BP can come down slowly. So this is quite common. So after some time, 20 minutes of rest, the BP would have normalized or at least reduced by 20. That's a sign that the patient has white coat hypertension. It may not totally normalize, but it's a sign that the doctor shouldn't be too aggressive in treating this high BP. So what I typically do is, even if the BP doesn't normalize, I ask the patient to go home, record the BP, or we can fix a machine which records the BP at home. It's called as ambulatory blood pressure monitoring. There's a machine which records the BP 24 hours when the patient goes home. Or nowadays, if with the more availability of these machines to record BP at home, patient can buy a BP machine, record it at home. Then typically the BP is normal. So that is the condition which confirms that the person does not actually have BP. When he comes to the clinic, he has high BP. So the doctor should go by the home value. If it is normal, person doesn't need treatment. Third thing, alcohol. Alcohol typically pushes the BP up, especially a few hours after alcohol intake, the BP goes up. And with chronic daily drinking of alcohol, the BP can stay high. So the person stays away from alcohol or even cigarette smoking. So till smoking one cigarette, BP can continue to be high. So the person is a chronic smoker, chain smoker, daily consumes alcohol, the BP can stay high. So the patient is advised to abstain slowly, not suddenly. So both are weaned off slowly. And as the person the blood level of alcohol and this nicotine comes down in the blood, slowly, the BP is going to come down. Next, some drugs like black coffee injection and some tablets also can push up the BP, especially young women who take these pregnancy pills, pills to postpone the pregnancy, which we call oral contraceptive pills. These can push the BP up. Some people consume tablets called steroids, prednisolone, for treatment of bronchial asthma. Others, some serious conditions like SLE, rheumatoid arthritis. For this, if the patients are taking steroids, the BP can go up. Some painkillers can also cause fluid retention and push the BP up. Some nasal decongestants. So for nasal blocks, if the person takes these drops, nasal drops to relieve the nasal block daily, or the person gets addicted to it slowly, then the BP also can stay high. So these are the few tablets. Apart from other cancer drugs, these are the common tablets which can push the BP up. So these are the common conditions. But there are some other diseases which you call the secondary hypertension. These are diseases basically. But if the disease is treated, the BP comes down. So the BP is because of a disease. When the disease is treated, this BP can come down. So commonly these diseases are from the kidney. So kidney failure pushes the BP up. Once the kidney failure is treated by any method, like dialysis or whatever, then slowly the BP will come down. There are some tumors called as pheochromocytoma. Typically, these conditions also have high BP. There's a typical history which these patients give. The BP suddenly shoots up, means the patient can have bursts of anxiety, flushing, redness of the skin, and palpitations. So these are the quiet symptoms, and these are episodic. I mean, this comes suddenly at one point in a day, usually sometimes in the evenings or something like that. So these tumors called pheochromocytomas, kidney failure, then diseases of a gland called parathyroidism. This parathyroid disease, hyperparathyroidism, this can come when with a secondary to kidney failure or due to other primary conditions of parathyroid. So diseases of parathyroid, diseases of thyroid, both low and high, means hypothyroid, hyperthyroid, hyperparathyroidism, kidney disease, and some other heart conditions like the usually these conditions called coarctation of aorta, which can come at birth or slowly increase, the gradient can increase as the person grows up, usually comes at birth. So coarctation of aorta can also cause high BP. So these are the conditions, basal diseases, when treated, BP is going to come down. So I gave you a list of conditions which are reversible. So with diseases or without diseases. So these are the conditions. So when somebody has high BP, it is not that he is branded for life. So the doctor needs to check for these. And as a patient, you should know that you have to get investigated for other conditions which can push the BP up. And these are treated, your BP is treated, and you don't need to take the tablets lifelong. Thank you.